A third model to device virtualization is the so-called split device driver model. This model is called split because all of the device accesses are controlled in a way that involves both a component that resides in the guest virtual machine and also a component that resides in the hypervisor layer. Specifically, device accesses are controlled using a device driver that sits in the guest VM called the front-end device driver. And then the actual driver for the physical device that is the regular device driver that's used by operating systems when they run natively. And this backend driver, referred to as backend, resides in the service VM in the case where we have a virtualization model that involves a service VM, or the host operating system in the case of type 2 virtualization. The point is that this backend should really be just the regular device driver that the service, the Linux OS, for instance, in the service VM would just be able to install and use, even if it's not running in a virtualized environment. Now, although this backend driver does not necessarily have to be modified, the frontend driver has to be modified because it explicitly needs to take the device operations that are made by the applications in the guest and then put them together in something that looks like a special message that will directly be passed to this backend component that's in the service VM. So this approach essentially applies only to paravirtualized guests that will be able to explicitly install these special front-end device drivers. What these really are, they look like wrappers for the actual device API. So the applications, potentially, they don't have to be modified. They will continue making the same kinds of requests for device operations. But this front-end device driver will treat these operations specially, will not attempt to actually issue accesses to the physical device. Instead, will create messages that will get passed to the service VM. One benefit of the approach is that it can eliminate the overheads that are associated with device emulation that the previous model required. Now we don't have to reverse engineer exactly what the guest OS is trying to do. The guest OS, via its front-end device driver, explicitly tells the virtualization layer, so overall these two components, what exactly is it that the guest VM requires. Another more subtle benefit of the approach is that now that we have this backend component that's centralized in that it will accept requests from all of the guest VMs in the system and then try to decide which one of those gets to execute the physical device access. Now, there's some opportunities for some better management of the shared device accesses. So to enforce some finer grain policies regarding fairness, regarding priorities, and those sorts of things.